Hi, I'm Ryan. I work in the media industry, and I've lived in China for almost 4 years now. 2021 marks the 100th anniversary of the founding of the Communist Party of China. And during those 100 years, its members have grown from a few dozen to over 95 million strong. Living in China, some of my friends and colleagues are part owners. Now you might be curious, what exactly are these people like? So to help you get a better understanding, I've invited other foreigners who also live in China to go and visit young party members through various careers in an attempt to paint a clearer picture by better getting to know their life and their work. We hope to discover who these people really are. And I personally hope that these experiences help foreigners in China and abroad better understand this country and its people. I had a lot of unique experiences when I first came to China. But surprisingly, the thing that was most foreign to me was the incredibly easy access to highly efficient and cost-effective transportation. And at the top of these has to be the Fuxing high-speed bullet train.
Sure, on paper, a plane is faster. The typical flight from Beijing to Changsha takes around 2.5 hours, while the train takes about 5.5.
But when you factor in getting to the airport early, checking your luggage, getting through security, and taxiing on the runway, they come out to about the same time. And plus, a train is much easier on your wallet. I'm on my way to Zhuzhou now to meet with Mr. Xu, one of the engineers behind the incredible marvel that is the Fuxing bullet train. And I hope to get a better grasp on what exactly makes these trains so amazing. I'm actually supposed to meet with him during this trip. But let's go find where he is.
Mr. Xu?
Hmm?
So good to finally meet you in person.
Yeah, you must be Ren.
Yep.
I'm Xu Shaolong, 是复兴号系列化动车组的研发团队成员之一，目前是中车株洲所的一名技术人员。
Correct me if I'm wrong, but you are the designer of the Fuxing Hao, yes?
No, I'm just in charge of propulsion system.
It's a part of the train. So you make the train move?
Yeah, I will show you something about the propulsion system from design to manufacture or testing or other things.
So the whole process?
Yeah.
I'm looking forward to it.
Yeah, you won't be disappointed.
我相信我们大多数乘客并不知道我们高铁怎么动起来的。它的所有的动力来源就是来自于车顶端的一根架空线，给列车提供了25000伏的交流电。如何把这25000伏的电这个正确的利用起来，去推动我们整车往前走？那么其实依靠的就是我们的牵引变流器。高压电流，比作我们这个人体的这种血液的话，那么其实我们的牵引变流器就是心脏。
So Ren, this is where I work. How do you feel about it?
Is this one your office?
Of course, no. It actually now house relic now. It almost 62 years old now.
Oh wow! Now it kind of feels like I'm walking into China railway history here.
Yes, and let's go and check it out.
Hello. 我们现在在这个调试的时候遇到一个问题，你帮我们看一下。
好的，我看一下。
对一堆数据在信号传输的时候有几个信号，它的传输是异常的，就这几个显红色的，你帮我们看一下。
Now I'm a little confused. Could you maybe help me out? What are we looking at here?
这些其实就是我们整个的列车网络系统上的数据。那么这里的话，一般来说我们用零或者一来代表这些数据的状态。
So this is the data from all of these machines we see here?
是，这些数据都是来自于我们在整个列车上装了很多的传感器。实际上我们这一套这个实验系统是把整个列车的网络系统都模拟出来了。
So sticking with our brain metaphor, each of these little different sensors would be like kind of like a neuron in your brain.
Yeah, yeah, and calculate. 那么实际上在我刚开始工作的时候，那我的工作就是去设计这些电路板。待会儿我会带你去看。
And when you say drawing circuit board, do you mean literally like pen and paper drawing?
No, look at him. We use computers with some professional tool software.
其实我大学毕业刚开始择业的时候，自己定的目标呢就是想做研发。我大概应该是画了三年的板子吧，在这三年里面还是锻炼出了我的责任心。
瑞恩，这是我的办公室。我们先在这里休息一下，喝口水。
好，
待会儿我带你去制造中心，看一下我们的复兴号的变流器的整个的生产过程。师傅好，师傅好。现在英文怎么样？
我今天在、遇到了一个美国的朋友，叫瑞恩，跟他打个招呼。
Hi there.
Hi, Ray.
Hi.
化文化，我认为。
下面我带你看一下我们的牵引控制系统是怎么被制造出来的。
All right.
So this is our the biggest manufacturer.
This place is huge.
Huge, yeah. And that's our destination converter.
So this is it, huh? I saw some people earlier working under one of these things. Is that safe? I feel like that would scare me a little.
你可以完全可以放心，我们这个变流器本身设计的就是悬挂在动车组的车厢下方的，可以到下面去。但是我们下去之前，首先还是要换上。
Oh, hard hat. Yeah.
Yes.
Here we go.
其实在我们整个变流器的下面的话，它是由整个的底盖板把它盖住了。那么我们唯一能看到的其实就是这套我们的散热系统。
So, does the system ever have any problems?
你问了一个很好的问题啊。其实我们的复兴号刚上线的时候，水冷系统里面其实我们需要去注入冷却液。一开始我们注液工艺没有做得非常的好，那么有一些小的气泡遗留在里面了。那么我们的保护系统就探测到这个问题。所以说就把列车停下来了。其实当天我知道这个问题之后，真的就没睡着觉。为什么呢？我觉得我们在之前的设计过程中一遍一遍的计算，一遍一遍的仿真，那么我们大量的工作居然被几个气泡给干翻了。那么其实真的让我在情感上是很难接受的。那么第二天早上很早去上班，当我回到一个我们熟悉的工作环境之后，我突然意识到，其实我们的复兴号是一种创新的过程，探索未知难免的就要碰到问题。让探索未知，然后把未知变成我们已知的知识的这样一种精神，这样一种动力，这样一种勇气，才让我们的复兴号达到现在的水平。
Okay, what is this place?
It's our testing center. We do a lot of tests on our 复兴 converters.Make sure it's up to standards.
Oh, all right, all right.
Having still not recovered from the manufacturing center processes, Mr. Xu threw me and the converter through the ringer.
大多数考生对考场的心情是复杂的，但是对于我个人来说，这个我从小到大我就没怕过考试。这个我觉得对我来说，或者对我的团队来说，我们觉得这样一个考场，恰恰是锻炼我们的地方。
China is a vast country, and from north to south, the high-speed rail will cross through the four seasons, mountains, and seas.
It's harder.
Yeah, you weren't kidding.
So it needs to go through dust testing.
Oh. Oh my, that's a lot of dust.
这是一个变流器。
Water testing, freeze testing, and electromagnetic testing.
Oh my goodness. What is this place? This is crazy.
啊，这个要请我们实验室的负责人陈工。
这是一个电子金融暗室，它可以创造一个干净的电子环境。我们可以在这里对产品的电子金融性进行测试。
这些都是用来吸收我们的电磁波，同时对声波也能吸收。你可以试一下。
Hello. First of all, I want to say thank you. This has been a very, very incredible experience. At least to me, it seemed that you have incredible passion for this.
Yeah, 你说的没错。其实，复兴号就像我的孩子一样。在复兴号上面，就像您讲的，确实我投入了很多的感情，在这个过程中。其实我也尤其在最开始的几年里面，我每一年可能都有二三十个通宵，为了来陪伴我们的复兴号。但是现在看起来，其实我当时的投入，我现在觉得是非常值得的。
2017年对我来说是有非常特殊意义的一年。这一年的话，是我们的复兴号高铁首次上线运营。也非常幸运的是，这一年我能够以党员的身份到现场为我们的复兴号高铁去保驾护航，因为我在这一年刚刚入了党。
作为一名党员，如果说有什么特质的话，那么我觉得就是我们更加的团结，我们所有人心往一处想，力往一处使，才能使我们的复兴号奔驰在广袤的中国大地上，使它玉电琼峰，永不止步。